Hey guys, on today's episode of Edgy Edge Functions, we'll be talking about how we can scrape any website by using AI. As we all know, scraping is a complex topic, from hosting your own puppeteer instance to understanding how a website works, especially with complex web apps today, where we have React.js, Next.js, it makes it very difficult for us to scrape a dynamic website. And this is where we can rely on AI. JigsawStack is a API provider that brings together a bunch of typically used APIs in one place. Let's take a look at the docs and see some of the APIs that is available. There's image generation API, translation API, AI chat API, and a bunch of powerful tools that you can use to build your next platform. Today, we'll be focusing on the AI scraper API, where it takes in two parameters. The URL, which is the website that you would like to scrape, and the prompts. The prompts basically tells the AI which portion of the websites that it needs to work on and the data that you want to extract from the website. So to start, let's try scraping Supabase owns store website. It's a dynamic site. It has a dynamic CSS library built on a modern web app framework. So let's try to extract the information that we want from this website. The first thing we need to do is head over to the dashboard, create a free account, and get your API key. So let's create an API key right over here, generate it. Let's copy this key and head over to our Supabase Edge function project and paste the key in your environment files. I assume you already have a deno function up and running. If not, we'll paste the link in the descriptions for you to learn how to set up your own Supabase Edge functions. Now we have a very simple deno serve function right over here. And the first thing we want to do is take in the parameters from the user, so the prompts and the URL. Here we will fetch the scrape API, as you can see in our documentation. We'll be pointing towards the scrape API base and the base URL to JigsawStack. We'll pass in the two prompts as needed and basically link it back with the API key, which will retrieve it from our environment files over here. And besides that, when we get the data, we will map it to the structure that we would like and then return the data. But for now, let's take a look what unstructured data looks like. And we'll make a thing. So the first thing you need to do is serve this API locally. To do that, first you run Supabase start, which I've already run. And then right after that, you can serve the function as needed. I've done up a simple demo over here to show you how it works. So I've repasted in the Supabase store URL and the two values that we want to get, the product title and all the product prices. And we're pointing to the local API right over here. So let's send a request to see what we get. Take it just a bit of seconds. Cool. As you can see, it told us exactly which CSS selectors it used to scrape the website and all the exact product names that we want from the website. As you can see, if you head back to Supabase Store's website, we'll see all the data exactly mapped out, like from the system. Right over here. So now the thing is, we want to clean this data up a little bit because it gives us a bunch of other information that we might not need for our current use case, like the width, the size of the elements that it scraped. So let's head back, let's bring back the mapping function and pass that as the written value. And let's call it again. The good thing about Supabase Edge functions is that you can make changes and it automatically reloads it for you locally. As you can see, now it's cleaner. We can see all the product titles in one list because we just mapped out the product titles and all the prices that we want. Simple as that. So you can use this for any website, any dynamic site, I think. So let's try it on Y Combinator's website as well. It's a dynamic social platform allowing people to constantly update and post new things. So let's copy this link and paste it right over here. Let's change the prompt to be more focused for what Y Combinator site does. So let's say post, this, since everything here is a post. So post title and post points. I think let's go for the points. Let's try to get these points. Perfect. And we send request. Similarly, it will try to understand this website and extract the relevant information based on the prompts we get. So prompt engineering is something that we need to do, basically understand what the website is going for and adjust our prompts based on what the site is focused on. As you can see, it extracted all the points we need without having to write a single piece of code and understand how the websites work. We don't have to inspect the element, take a look at the CSS code, it does the work for us. The interesting thing is that running an AI scraper can get expensive if you keep running this every minute or every second, if you need to scrape a website very actively. But what you can do is also pair it with a typical scraper from JigsawStack. So it doesn't always have to be powered by the AI scraper. So let me show you how a normal scraper from JigsawStack works. You can, for example, if you want to scrape it from Y Combinator site, and we already scraped it once from the AI scraper, we can copy over the CSS selectors that we need. So let's adjust the parameters over here. So let's say selectors instead, and we'll copy the selectors that we exactly want. Paste it in here. And let's go for the price, same sort of points. Copy this over here, and we'll paste it right over here. And we'll go over here. Now, we can go back to the documentation and take a look at the normal scraper. What the parameters we need? We need a URL, okay, we already have that. And we need elements. So it's a child of selector. So let's pass that in. So now, since we have selectors right over here, we have to map it. Nice. AI does the work for me. So we get selectors right up here. That's it. And now we just change the path URL to follow this exactly, which is v1/scrape. Now we have a typical scraper that will work a lot faster and a lot cheaper. Since we already got the CSS selectors using AI, we can pass those CSS selectors to a typical scraper to do the same work a lot faster. And now we map the data back as we need and basically return it as a response. So we can send it as a request right over here. Cool, that's it. And this works without the AI as well. So you can use both the AI scraper and the non-AI scraper hand in hand together to give you the same results when needed. So one example is when you're trying to scrape an e-commerce site daily. At the start of the day, you can use the AI scrapers to get the CSS selectors. And throughout the entire day, you can scrape it using the typical scraper to save cost. And you can repeat that action day on day without needing a single piece of code or understanding the website structure. And especially as the website changes over time, you will never need to update your scripts because the AI will do the hard work for you to pull out the data that you need. And that's how we can scrape both sides. Check out JigsawStack. Happy to take some feedback and catch you guys around.